This year has been a tough one. We have faced so many obstacles, and our lives are only just beginning. Obstacles that aren't just us getting ready for prom, obstacles that aren't just us trying to pass a course, but no, this time, this obstacle is us trying to get past the death of two people that were very close to us. Two of our very own Dream Team members, Nick Robinson and Donald Howler. Now, Donald, dear Donald, he was very unfunny. Most of the jokes that came from him were us relentlessly bullying him, making fun of how terrible his life was. But that didn't keep him down. No, he rose up from the ashes of neglect and abuse like a phoenix and showed how much of a complete jerk he was to all of us. But we didn't just lose a person who was in like three of our videos. No, we lost a founding member, Nick. I remember this one time when we were only freshmen. And it's just so weird, you know, like any of us could have been in that freak accident that none of us need to talk about, and I don't need to go into specifics here because we all totally know what happened to him. We all totally remember what happened to him, so I don't need to explain it for anyone outside of this group.
Oh my god.
Please, continue.
How did you come back?
Oh, the witches summoned me back from the dead.
All right.
It's just hard. He was such a good friend of mine. Even though we got into it a lot, he was really talented. He was really funny. He was so cool. And one of the last things he said to me was, "You're dead to me, Skylar." And now he's literally dead to all of us. Oh.
Is there anything anybody would like to say about Nick? All right. Is there anything anybody would like to say about Donald?
Skylar's really beaten up about this.
Well, I mean, one of our friends, and Donald, is dead. It's just crazy how many of our friends are just dying these days.
Yeah, I get it, I guess. I think that's Skylar.
Is everything okay, Skylar?
Yes, no, maybe. I don't know. Can you repeat the question?
Is everything okay, Skylar?
You know, I really hate death. People I've known since I was born, people I've admired, people I talked to yesterday, they're dying. They're living their entire lives, and I'm just wasting mine.
Well, not everything's about you.
Oh, you just haven't figured out what you're gonna do yet.
Why haven't I? Everyone else has. I mean, Collin's rich, he's set. David's gonna be a famous lion tamer. Brandon's writing comics,
And you are moving to Texas in a month to become a famous YouTube celebrity.
No, you're moving to Texas.
And why would I do something so stupid?
I have no idea. It's a huge leap of faith. Like, nothing is certain.
All I'm trying to say is that you at least have an idea. We're just getting prepped a little earlier than you.
It's nothing to worry about.
Mm-hmm. I just wish we could go out on a bang. Like, I want the dream team, if this is how life's gonna go, to go on a bang.
Ew. No, what did you have in mind?
Well, if we could, I'd like to go on like a road trip, just hang out.
Would we be going anywhere?
Well, I know this spot. We can go like camping, get away from life, just finish dream team, you know?
Like a hangout to end all hangouts.
Yeah, basically.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Come on, you don't gotta do this for me just because.
No. We want to do it too. It's a great idea.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh my god. Oh my god, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, guys. I can't believe we're actually doing this. No, I have to pack.
But school isn't over yet.
Well, I guess we're going. You're driving.
You gonna help me with the bags, Dave? Go team.
This is it. Ooh, this is the place. And I just have to say, thank you so much for doing this with me.
Happy to help.
All right, let's get set up. Where's the tent?
And the car.
Why is it in the car?
Well, when I asked for help, you guys left. So I left too. I left it in the car.
What about our stuff?
What about our clothes?
It's with the tent. In the car. Don't worry. I brought some extra shirts for you guys so you guys don't get all smelly.
David.
You didn't help either.
David.
Well, I mean, you can go ahead and go get it.
Oh, but I picked up the spot and I already helped so much and I just... Marcus, please.
Nope.
Marcus.
Nope.
David.
No.
David.
No.
Marcus! You know, I don't really understand what's so hard about going back to the car and grabbing our stuff.
I don't know, Skylar. What is so hard about doing that?
You know what, you're right. I'm really making this all about me, aren't I? And it's not. It's about us, as a team. See? Karibo Squad! Yeah. Yeah, don't worry, guys. Tomorrow will be much better.
Where am I? What is going on here? It's like that one movie. I don't know where I was going with. What? Am I getting smaller?
You all right, buddy?
Where are we?
The woods.
Huh. Weird.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Shouldn't we have like a tent or something?
Dave and you wouldn't get your crap out of my car, so I left it in there.
Huh. Coolio. So, what are we doing today?
We thought you had something planned.
Nah. No, not really. Maybe we can go to that, the field, the one we came in on, and, just talk for a bit so we figure something out.
All right.
You know what really sucks is, that budget cup Batman's probably never gonna finish, never, ever.
Yeah.
Like, we had so much great projects planned, and they all just, poof. We all just gave up on them.
We didn't give up. We just ran out of time. Our projects were too big.
Well, I mean, we still have time before school's over, so once we get back, we can just finish some of them up.
It wouldn't be the same.
Why?
You'd have to recast.
So?
Hey, you know what? What was your guys' favorite project that was never made? Like anything we had a script for or we started filming and it just never was able to be finished?
I'd have to say probably Dream Team Dies.
The Halloween special we had planned?
Yeah.
Oh, dude, that would have been that's a good one. What about you, David?
I'd probably say Baking Bad.
That one we had the full script for. That one was really funny. What about you? Wow, that is a great one. Good one.
Yeah?
You know, you were such an idiot.
What?
You don't think. You just do things. You're moving to Texas on a maybe. You're getting all these jobs before you move. What, like, you remember what happened in Tampa?
Yeah? What? What happened in Tampa?
I don't need to explain what happened to Tampa because all three of us already know what happened in Tampa and I don't need to say anything to anyone else.
Yeah? Why are you acting like such a weirdo right now? Where is this coming from?
And you just really frustrate me sometimes, but you're such a great spirit to be around. Like, you're so
No! Don't do this to me!
Do what?
You're acting so two-faced right now. Dude, just you get all crazy emotional about everything, and then you act like nothing ever happened.
I don't do that at all. God. David, do I do that? Be honest with me. I won't get mad. Just tell me, do I do that?
I wouldn't call it two-faced.
God damn it!
Should we go after him?
No. Let him be all mopey and emo for however long. He'll come back. This sucks.
Hey guys, I just wanted to say sorry about everything. If you guys want to go home, I get it. Just forget about all of this.
This isn't just about you. We wanted a break too. We wanted to come out here and life's hard. Why not take a break?
Yeah, you're right. So you guys don't hate me?
Maybe.
I'll take it.
Jesus.
Also, I was thinking, tomorrow I could go to the car actually and get our stuff. And I had brought a bunch of little like frisbees, and I brought a bunch of snacks and a bunch of fun things and a bunch of grills and stuff like that we can all do together.
Cool.
Yeah. It is cool, David. Karibo Squad.
SD card?
It's in here.
Sorry.
Whoa! I thought we were using finger guns! Oh.
Well, didn't I make it oopsie doodle shenanigans? You gave me cancer. Now I'm gonna give it to you.
Skylar! It's Marcus! He's the key! You were right about Texas. You've always been right! Am I too soon? I don't really care, this is a dream.
Dave, what's going on?
This Skylar's gone, I can't find him.
Did you check the car?
Yeah, he wasn't there.
Well, I guess we better go find him. Found him.
Let's take him to the car.
Ow! What are you doing?
He kicked me!
It was an accident!
So? Everything's an accident with him!
You know, this is a really inappropriate time. He's having a seizure.
Let's do it anyway.
I'm just so uncharacteristically upset about this. He wanted to come out here to feel better, but all he's done is act mildly annoying for 2 days.
Yeah, but that's just who he is.
I'm kind of used to it by this point.
Hey. I just kind of woke up from my seizure over there and wanted to say I'm really sorry, guys, about everything.
It's fine.
No, it's not.
No, it's fine, Skylar. Sometimes you might be obnoxious and get crazy emotional, but that's just who you are. For us, we've been preparing all our lives, but for you, life came out of nowhere, and we can't understand that. You just want to hold on to your childhood as long as you can, and trust us, we do too. Responsibility sucks.
Yeah, and what kind of friends would we be if we hung out with you for all these years, and then one day just decided you were dead to us?
Really, really bad friends.
Exactly.
Thanks, guys.
No problem.
You should probably go ahead and go home. You coming, Skylar?
Maybe not.
Why?
I don't know, I was thinking we don't have to leave. We can stay here in the forest, like, forever.
I'm not doing that.
Just think about that. No responsibilities. We could do whatever we want. No jobs, no school, no work, no nothing. It'd be perfect.
He's not wrong.
I don't know, it just seems foolish to throw away such promise for a great life.
Yeah, coming from the guy with the awesome plan on moving to Texas.
I mean, I'd be okay with throwing my plans away. Lion tamers get scratched a lot.
Exactly. And let's be real here. This place has changed us. I don't think we've ever been this close in our entire lives.
I just...
Listen. You don't have to say anything else. I'm staying with Skylar.
Thank you, Dave. Marcus, I guess we'll see you on the flip side.
Later, dude.
Marcus. Rock on.
Marcus. Follow your dream.
Marcus, don't you dare talk about this.
Marcus, are you not entertained?
Marcus, Jesus, dude.
Marcus.
Marcus! Marcus! What's in the box? Oh, and Marcus! Drop dead.
Now wait one moment. Karibo Squad, Task Force Revengers, Wolfpack, No Nudes, Dream Team!
And so, everyone stayed in the woods for another 3 hours. With the Dream Team officially finished, Marcus went on to actually get his dream job at the company Rooster Teeth in Austin, Texas. He later found a nice house to live in and built up a successful life. Unfortunately, the success got to him, and he was found dead, intoxicated, and penniless on the streets only 2.5 weeks after getting the job. David went on to become the world's third greatest lion tamer, and found moderate success. At least I think so.
I have no idea what a lion tamer makes. It's probably good money. Hey, Brian, look that up.
What?
Look up how much a lion tamer makes on average.
All right. About 90,000.
Weekly?
Yeah.
Holy Jesus, and he's the third best. Dude, David's making bank. Never mind, sorry, got off subject. Nick and Donald are still dead. Like, super dead. Collin is still rich. Good for him. And Brandon is still hanging out at the school for some reason. And he's still very much Jewish. And as for Skylar, well, he ended up leading the greatest life of all. The life he's always wanted.
And that's the story of the road trip. Pretty good, huh? You're such a great listener. You know, I really miss those guys. It was such a long time ago. But hey, you wanna go hang out over by the old campsite? Where it takes place. Yeah, because it's a true story. I bet you didn't know that one, huh? You know, there's actually a mushroom patch right next to it where I was eating them all up because, you know, David, f***ing David, forgot to bring the bags. So you know what? I was just munching them all up. And yeah, living on the best. Woo!